So as we know, the sixth charge was dropped. That was a misdemeanor gun charge against Kyle Rittenhouse. Let's bring in outspoken Second Amendment supporter, musician Ted Nugent, also a friend of mine. Ted, you know, you're watching this case alongside the rest of us. This feels like this is self-defense versus vigilanteism on trial in Kenosha, Wisconsin. What are your thoughts?
Well, my thoughts are based on the overwhelming evidence. So to you, Eric, I say ditto, ditto, ditto. I've been listening to you. You're bringing forth truth, logic, and common sense that good Americans all understand. We see it with our own eyes. That this court case even exists is a manifestation of cultural abandonment in America. The prosecutor, pure rot. The rioters, rotten human beings, just nasty, nasty thugs. Kyle Rittenhouse, I'm sending him a lifetime supply of good ammo. This guy, this young 17-year-old kid, was exactly what the founding fathers wanted all Americans to be, to stand up good over evil. Kyle Rittenhouse, good. Rioters and thugs and attackers and assaulters and career criminals, evil. And what we have here too, Eric, I hope everybody would write down this colloquialism. It's a representative colloquialism. Engineered recidivism. Our court system, our totally failed court system, is intentionally engineering recidivism. They know these people are going to repeat their vicious, violent crimes, and the so-called justice system continues to let them out to do it. And when a good citizen stands up and goes, no, I have an instinctual moral obligation to try to neutralize evil, this court case happens, and it breaks the hearts and sickens good Americans that know the purest instinct of man is to defend oneself. And that's all Kyle Rittenhouse did.
Yeah, yeah. And you, I'll add another layer to this. Is it's the media's on the side of the left, and this prosecutor, for some reason, this became a black-white issue. One thing that really bothered us, and we talked about it a couple of days ago in a monologue, is that even the Milwaukee Sentinel Journal at one point agreed with the prosecutor that said that Kyle Rittenhouse was not old enough to hold the gun that he was holding, the AR-15. Turns out he was. Now, you'd think the Milwaukee Sentinel Journal would have someone who would fact-check a prosecutor, a vengeful prosecutor looking for a win, and find out that, yes, Kyle was within his right, and it took a year. It took a year and almost went to a jury before the people, America, realized that he was allowed to have that gun.
Well, once again, there is no real debate amongst honest people whether the right to keep and bear arms is an individual gift from God. And the founding fathers wrote it down in case some punk wanted to play King George again. I have a new song out right now. It's a love song. It's called Come and Take It. And what these leftists, what the media and the Democrats and the Marxists and big tech and Hollywood and academia have to learn is that when the failed justice system and the obscene court system continues to put these vicious people onto our streets, never in the history of the United States of America has it been more important or righteous to keep and bear arms. And that's all that Kyle Rittenhouse was doing. I know a bunch of U.S. Marine heroes. I spent the day on the 246th birthday with the United States Marine Corps with a 96-year-old hero that became a Marine when he was a teenager. Well, if you can become a Marine as a teenager and go up the Iwo Jima to stop evil, then certainly you have the right to keep and bear arms to protect yourself. And I'd just like to salute Kyle Rittenhouse. What a tactically trained young man. He did everything right. And our society is coming down against good, and these numbnuts are supporting evil. We are paying attention here, and I think we reacted in Virginia recently, and when we elect a truck driver over the mafia punks in New Jersey, I would like to think that the left might want to take notice that we, the people, are now wide awake, and we see with our eyes, and we hear what you're saying on the left, and we're not going to take it anymore. God bless Kyle Rittenhouse. Great, great American.
Ted Nugent, always outspoken, always good having you on The Balance. Ted, thank you, and good friend of mine. Thank you for being here as usual. Hey, don't forget Ted's new single.